एंड आई वुड नाउ मूव ऑन टू आवर नेक्स्ट स्पीकर फॉर टुडे, आदरणीय कर्तव्य शर्मा जी. सो सीईओ सीनियर मेंटर आदरणीय कर्तव्य जी इज करंटली सीनियर प्रोडक्ट मैनेजर एट अमेजोन. एंड आदरणीय कर्तव्य जी हैज हैड अ ट्रिमेंडस जर्नी थ्रू आउट विच इज बीन सच अ सोर्स ऑफ इंस्पिरेशन टू ऑल ऑफ अस. एक्सट्रीमली प्रोफिशिएंट कर्तव्य जी डिड हिज बीटेक इन कंप्यूटर साइंस फ्रॉम आईआईटी वाराणसी बीएचयू, वेंट ऑन टू डू हिज फर्स्ट मास्टर्स इन आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस फ्रॉम द कोलंबिया यूनिवर्सिटी, got a perfect GPA, topped his entire class, went on to Johns Hopkins University to do his second master's in international economics and strategic studies, worked directly with Microsoft, with Bill Gates at Microsoft, has also worked directly with the US government, the then Barack Obama administration, and currently is proficient in over 13 programming languages, in artificial intelligence, in international financial markets, international economics, micro and macroeconomics, and so much more. In fact, he has been a star alumnus, like I mentioned earlier, of the world's biggest educational institutes, and currently is at a very senior position at Amazon Bangalore. So without further ado, I would now invite Adarne Kartaveji to please address us on today's session on digital finance. Being a pioneer in the field himself, we are very fortunate to hear directly from Kartaveji. So I now hand over to you, Adarne Kartaveji. Om Namah Shivaya.
Om Namah Shivaya, Sharda ji. Thank you for the kind introduction. Please, can someone confirm they can hear me clearly?
Ji, Adarne Kartaveji. Om Namah Shivaya.
I'm sharing my screen. Please let me know if you're able to see it.
Ji. We're able to see the screen.
Thanks. So once again, Om Namah Shivaya to everybody. And thanks for the kind introduction, Shraddha ji. But my only and only introduction is that I am a selfless disciple of Param Pujanya Rashtriya Rishi Lahiri Guruji. And that is the introduction I want everybody to remember. With that said, today we will talk about digital finance, but we'll talk about in a slightly different nuanced way of understanding it. We will understand the topic, the vast field, from two perspectives. One is how it applied to India as a nation and empowered and transformed our nation. Second, how a similar journey CEI took and what is the role of you, our CEI family members, our interns in that. With that said, let's start off with the state of India around 2013. When Narendra Modi ji came to power, he had the vision of transforming India into a 5 trillion economy. And he knew to do that, digitization and digital inclusion with respect to finance has to be the strongest pillar which will guide India into a 5 trillion economy. But the state at that time was very, very poor. India, with respect to digital transactions per capita, was way behind smaller countries such as Singapore. And there were multiple challenges to transform India into a digital finance hub. You all recall, I mean, till now we are all cash habituated. Only like 1-2% people give tax. And even if somebody was using credit card back in 2013, it was a very subpar experience. You have to take out your card physically. If something happens, you're not sure whether you will get the money back, when you will get the money back. So the challenges were tremendous. And anybody would have gotten below the burden of those challenges, but not our Honorable Prime Minister. He went out to have a 10-year roadmap, 10-year plan to transform India into a 5 trillion economy by 2023. And how did he do in a piecemeal basis? As Param Pujanya Gurudev says, start with the end goal in mind. So Modi ji had this end goal in mind. And picture this, that the man sitting in this image that you can see is the Nukkadwala Kirana shop owner in maybe your city, in maybe tier 4, tier 5 city, or maybe in the rural and tribal part of India. And just imagine Suman ji, sitting in Canada, wants to give loan to this person for his immediate need. And the need could be that he wants to expand his shop or he wants to have more supplies because he's expecting that Diwali is going to come and more people are going to shop from his shop. How can Sumanji sitting in Canada provide short-term or long-term loans to ensure that this gentleman sitting here in a rural city of India is able to not only get the money instantaneously, but also use it for expanding his shop and also pay back seamlessly to Sumanji back in Canada? That was what Modi ji wanted to accomplish. And the first thing he did, I mean, if you look at it from a holistic perspective, before Sumanji can transfer money to this guy has to have a digital identity. Otherwise, how will Sumanji know whom he has paid loans to? So the first thing which he did, and if you look closely at the first 3 years of Modi government, 2013 to 2016, he took an Aadhaar project, which was still had much of a promise, still hadn't seen, you know, the fulfillment or the success, and he turned it around. So many people got the digital identity. And similar thing CEI did when we were starting our holistic empowerment Mahasadhana. We also created identities for our rural and tribal brothers and sisters. Doing that, it allowed, by a simple ration card or a bank account, it allowed them to avail various central and state government schemes, whether it be Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana or it be direct benefit transfers, or even when you form a self-help group, you need to have a bank account so that money transfer can happen. So you see the starting point of holistic empowerment, whether it be India or what CEI did, started off with creating identity for people with the ultimate aim of empowerment. Okay, but with this foundational layer or foundational step done, it was time to shift gears, because just having identity will not help you. How do you change the behavior of India as a nation so that people, by their own volition, transfer money digitally or partake in digital finance? And that is where the demonetization step kind of came into picture. There were various strategic reasons for demonetization. I'm not going into that. Demonetization was definitely not done only to have an impetus on digital finance. Definitely not. But one of the outcome of that was that it created an ecology. It caused the change in the behavior of people, but it also created an ecosystem or an ecology by which various apps mushroomed and gained national consciousness. Paytm became a household name after demonetization. Google Pay, WhatsApp Pay, which is going to come, Amazon Pay, Phone Pay, FreeCharge, MobiKwik, you name it, everything came along. And government also came up with UPI and Bheem. So that one major step of demonetization helped in creating an ecology of players, which eventually led to an empowerment. And lo and behold, same thing was followed by CEI as well. You all must have heard from Shri Bhaiji, the Walk for Empowerment initiative and the tribal youth festival that we organized. And that had a very, very profound impact on the whole ecosystem of the rural and tribal parts of Maharashtra. Here you see in the picture is the Walk for Empowerment initiation. Here you see the tribal youth festival that we organized. Now, once this happens, you know, a Mahotsav or a festival happens in a tribal part where it is not the norm, what happens is people get a view of what it means to come together as a community. And they themselves find ways to empower themselves. For example, you see this tribal women self-help groups taking self-initiative to cook food for the tribal youth festival. You see, behind the tribal youth festival is happening. And this was their first tiny but definitive step towards empowering themselves, towards taking the first step towards entrepreneurship. And that one step, you know, if you're not used to it and you get such an ecology, it's a very, very profound transformational impact for people in the rural and tribal parts. During the walk for empowerment, similarly, they gave food to eat and drinks to the people who came from the urban part of India. Now, this is very important. Tribal Youth Festival was getting together a tribal community. But the walk for empowerment was when people from urban parts of India came and saw firsthand what was happening in the tribal parts. And our beloved Milinji is a prime example of taking something from the rural part and then consuming it in the urban part, giving confidence to the youth if they win the tribal youth festival. And that one notion, one idea of confidence leads to another ideas. And this is a transformation story of Mr. Ravi Pawarji, who amongst his tribe is the only one who has, you know, studied from a graduation perspective. And he felt so empowered after coming in touch with CEI, after the empowerment ecology that he was exposed to, that he is himself coming up with so many initiatives to not only empower himself, but also empower his full tribe, full community. And that is the power of shifting gears, whether it was demonetization leading to so many ecosystem of apps, or the fact that we had the Tribal Youth Festival or the Walk for Empowerment creating entrepreneurship opportunities in themselves. And now switching gears, once Modi ji had made the foundational aspect of digital finance, which was identity and the digital transfer of money, his next step was to announce to the world. And if you have not heard Mr. Modi's speech of last year Independence Day, I would urge you to go back and listen to it, where he talks about the MSME sector and also about how will we ensure that a digitized loan is given to them where they do not have to go to the banks. And MSMEs form the core foundation, the backbone of our economy. If we can transform that, which is the linchpin, the whole economy will transfer. And digital loans is the right step for that. And he announced to the world. So that this, Sumanji is sitting in Canada, by the click of the button, can transfer money to that local kirana shop owner in Raigarh, and he can confirm the receipt of the money. That is very much a possibility now, once the foundational layer was set up. And how that will be actually fructified is this gentleman, Mr. Ambani, will make this vision a reality. Because for Sumanji to transfer the money digitally to that kirana shop owner, that kirana shop owner has to be connected to the internet. And you will be surprised that only 30-40% of the population of India have smartphones. Most of the population has feature phone. Now, feature phone, at least 10 years back, 6 years back, didn't have connection to the internet. That is where the game changer geophone came into picture, which is a very kind of a midway between feature phone and smartphone, but has basic connection to internet. As Mr. Sujayji was saying, so many people emit so much data. Data is not the oil, data is the IP. But essentially, with this digital identity and digital footprint, Sumanji will be able to transfer money to the right set of candidates who should get the money and who will be able to pay him back. So this was the game changer. Now, to make CEI's vision a reality, who will be the game changer? You, our CEI Yodhas, our CEI intern family. At this moment, you know, you have had few weeks into the internship. You would have faced a challenge that, you know, how will I raise the money? And everybody faces this challenge. Modi ji faced this challenge in 2013. How will he go about it? And he went about it in a very strategic manner, in a very piecemeal manner. Similarly, at right now, you would have either more funds than what you have anticipated or less funds. There could be just two possible opportunities. And the idea is, how do you look back and do course correction? Or how do you double down on what you're doing successfully? How do you find that collaboration opportunities? How do you find opportunities to learn from CEI senior mentors to transform yourself with fundraising in mind? And there are certain principles that, you know, we as an organization, every senior leader talks about: being egoless, being selfless, and being fearless. And those you will see manifest in any and every successful project. For example, when Modi ji worked on Aadhaar, he could have said, no, this was somewhat started in Congress, I'm not going to touch it. But he kept his ego aside and recognized the power of the project and continued on it. Similarly, demonetization was, somebody said it was a suicidal move by Modi ji. Nobody will vote him to power again, but he still went ahead with that because he was convinced. And then fearless, the way he's envisioning the digital loan economy to catapult India into a $5 trillion economy is an example of a fearless leader. And you see that in other leaders as well. For example, Bill Gates famously left Microsoft to eradicate malaria in Africa. And there's no connection in coding, software development, and malaria in Africa. But he was selfless. Similarly, Elon Musk had a very famous and successful company, PayPal. After that, he didn't just sit down. He went on to change the world. SpaceX, Tesla, you name it. He just changed the world. And Sundar Pichai is the prime example of being egoless. He was from metallurgical background. And now he's leading the most tech-heavy company in the world. How do you do that? Obviously, you know, you have to keep aside your ego for the time being and ensure that at the starting, you are the right cog in the wheel of the large company. But also, he had right mentorship at the right moment. And that was the essential reason why he catapulted to the CEO of Google. And this is your opportunity, because you have access to so many senior leaders. You can also catapult yourself to be the next successful leader and the emerging leader of India. And you should have certain end goals in mind from this internship experience. You should strive for getting the maximum learning out of it. Understand what it means to have a principle-centric living and live that. Last but not the least, you should definitely strive for the letter of recommendation and the certificate of excellence from CEI. And I'm sure if you do this diligently, sincerely, you will become a leader. But more importantly, you will become a sustainable leader, which is able to, as Milindji was saying, be resilient. As Puneetji so eloquently told us, be a leader. And that definitely is going to happen. With that, I will end. Om Namah Shivaya.